Hi, we're at the Hawke Convention 2021 in person, which is great after what's happened over the last year, and good to see lots of people.
Nice change. Yeah.
Today I'm with Benji...
Blenheim,
thanks, Benji.
Blevin.
Benji Blenheim from John Deere, and we're talking about precision ag.
Yep.
And I guess, you know, we've talked about that for a long time, and really we're wanting to see what's coming to the market now, and you know, what's on the horizon for the growers, what can they expect from it?
Yeah, absolutely. So today we have a focus on yield documentation in veggie and root crops. So, you know, there's some growers out there that are seeing real value in being able to yield document, and root crops can be anything from potatoes, sweet potatoes, onions, carrots, anything of that like. But yeah, value in being able to generate that yield map and understand where you have variability in the paddock. So if you have an understanding of where you have variability, you can then start to target and understand what's driving that, whether it be soil type, whether it be a nutrient deficiency, you know, whether it be elevation, which might be disturbing how water's flowing across that ground. So there's a lot of drivers there, of course.
Benji, the Broadacre guys have been doing yield monitoring for a long time, haven't they?
Yeah, absolutely.
They've had it on their headers.
Yep.
You know, and I guess we're trying to learn from them, and they're going, well, they're making a lot of decisions on their yield maps now. We've got some challenges in horticulture and veggie production. You know, potatoes you talked about. What are some of those challenges?
Yeah, absolutely. And there's, you know, you're right in saying that there are some challenges. You know, from a potato perspective, as an example, you can get an accumulation of soil on the potatoes, particularly in wet conditions. And there's a couple of things you can do to combat that, which sometimes involves changing maybe your conveyor system as you harvest to allow more conveying, which allows dirt to disturb and fall off that off the potato. And the other thing is that you can post-calibrate. Obviously, it takes a little bit of work to do that as well. But I think by understanding and knowing that that challenge, and you're trying to work with that, and at the end of the day, that the data that you get still tells a story around where you have variability.
Yeah.
And that's a key indicator for us, and something that you can work with.
So how do you see it playing out in the veggie industry? And you know, what sort of advantages do you think, you know, having a yield map, being able to see a nice pretty picture of where you're getting your top yield, where you're making your money from, what parts of the paddock?
Yeah, so I think the advantage, as you say, it's around understanding where you're performing poorly and what you can do to improve that area. It's about amelioration of the soil. And it's also about maximizing the potential yield you have in some areas that are doing really well. So, you know, you might be redistributing what you're applying into areas that might provide more yield, and you're already capped out in some of those poor performing areas, and you're going to start working on that. So that's the value. And from a sustainability point of view, you're only applying what you need to apply as well.
So
you're not over applying in areas that don't need it or won't see response.
Yeah. And what's, you know, what sort of allowed us to do this now? You know, we've got your John Deere tractors. What's on them? What technologies on them that's allowing us to do this?
Yeah, I think it's a good question. We've got embedded receivers. You know, you can attach receivers, displays. Those are two key technologies. You obviously need a receiver to provide georeference locations to that yield that you're measuring. And then the other thing is connectivity. So the tractors are all connected to the cloud. The data that you capture, and that one of the biggest challenges has also been getting data off of load cells and into a system where you can view that information effectively and analyze it. By having machines that are automatically connected to the cloud and the data flowing wirelessly, you can access that data in almost near real time and then start to make decisions from it as quickly as possible.
Yeah. Excellent. And you know, if we look to our Broadacre cousins that have been doing this for a long time, what have you seen as big jumps forward when they've had yield maps?
Well, I think it's really just the adoption of variable rate technology and minimizing the costs and really maximizing profitability by understanding where. But over time, you start to develop a better and better picture if you're capturing. And that can also be another challenge. You know, you might only get a yield map of the same crop every 3 years or 4 years in this horticulture scenario, as opposed to in small grains where you might come back every couple of years. So
I mean, I guess in terms of vegetables, the difference is that the costs are mainly about harvesting rather than, you know, the input costs are smaller.
Yes, yep,
so
absolutely.
really what veggie growers would like as a yield map would be how to maximize the yield in their good areas.
Yes.
Because that's where their profit comes from.
Absolutely, yep. If we can get more product out, that's a great result, yep.
Okay, well, thanks for your time, Benji,
and
enjoy the rest of Hawke Conventions 2021.
Yeah, appreciate the time. Thanks very much.
Yep. Thanks.
Cheers.